we are live. Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. Nyana Nasabi Jose.
Nyan Megan.
And in this video, we are going to do something different.
What are we gonna do?
We are going to react to a special video. So I want to introduce you to this amazing dance form called Kathakali. So I introduced you to Kerala's martial arts, Kalaripayattu.
Yeah.
But I want to introduce you to Kerala's dance form. It's very unique to Kerala.
Mm-hmm.
It's called Kathakali. So this is an ancient dance form. It basically, so the dancers wear like elaborative clothes and they do a lot of makeup and there's a reason to it. Basically what they do is like they dance, but they also like portray a story. A story that basically tells a tale from the Hindu religion, as far as I remember. And basically we have a lot of epic stories, and Kathakali is basically a dance form that kind of portrays a story from those epics. And it actually takes a lot of practice. And what they say is that if you master this dance form, you can pick up any dance form.
Wow.
Yeah, in the world, any dance form. Because it's Kathakali is very difficult. And it takes years of training for the dancers to even like perform their first act on stage. Years.
Wow.
Several years.
Mm-hmm.
And you'll see why. So this is the link that I found on YouTube. I hope this video will... I haven't looked at the video, but I'm guessing this would give a proper introduction to Kathakali. When I was a kid, I used to go to Kerala, like I told you, and I used to go to such festivals where they used to like put up acts, and that's how I recollect all of the Kathakali tales and everything. It's really interesting. Back then, I wasn't able to understand much, but then growing up, I was able to understand the true cultural significance. So it's really interesting, and I am really excited for you to check this dance form. So why don't we get down to the reaction and have a discussion right after. And I believe we have subtitles.
Practicing.
Oh yeah, that's
നമ്മുടെ മനസ്സും കൂടി ചേരുമ്പോഴാണ് ഈ കണ്ണിന്റെ യഥാർത്ഥ പ്രകടനം പ്രേക്ഷകരിലേക്ക് എത്തുന്നത്. അല്ലെങ്കിൽ വെറും മൂവ്മെന്റ് മാത്രമായിരിക്കും.
വിൻഡോസ് ടു ദ സ്റ്റോറി.
ഈ സ്ഥാപനത്തിന്റെ പേര് കേരള കലാമണ്ഡലം. സ്ഥാപിച്ചിട്ട് 87 വർഷമായി. എന്റെ പേര് കലാമണ്ഡലം രവികുമാർ. ഞാനിവിടെ കഥകളി വേഷം അധ്യാപകനാണ്. കഥകളി എന്ന് ഉദ്ദേശിക്കുന്നത് പുരാണത്തിലെ ഒരു പ്രത്യേക അഭിനയം. ഇതിൻ്റെ ഏറ്റവും വലിയ പ്രത്യേകത ഈ ചതുർവിധ അഭിനയം, അംഗങ്ങളെ കൊണ്ടുള്ള ആംഗിക അഭിനയം, വാക്കുകളെ കൊണ്ടുള്ള വാചിക അഭിനയം, ആഹാരങ്ങൾ വേഷഭൂഷാദികളെ കൊണ്ടുള്ള ആഹാര അഭിനയം, ഭാവപ്രകടനത്തിൻ്റെ സാത്വിക അഭിനയം, കണ്ണ് തന്നെയാണ് ഏറ്റവും പ്രധാനം. കണ്ണ് തന്നെയാണ്, അതായത് മുഖം ഉൾപ്പെട്ട
അതിൽ
ഏറ്റവും പ്രധാനം. അതുകൊണ്ട് തന്നെയാണ് കണ്ണിനെ പ്രാക്ടീസ് ചെയ്ത് നമ്മുടെ ഇഷ്ടത്തിനനുസരിച്ച് ചലിപ്പിക്കാൻ പ്രാക്ടീസ് കൊണ്ട് നേടിയെടുക്കുകയാണെങ്കിൽ. ഇവിടെ പഠിക്കാൻ വരുന്ന കുട്ടിയെ 13 വയസ്സിൻ്റെ അവിടെ വരുന്നു. അപ്പൊ ഏതാണ്ട് ഒരു 12 വർഷത്തോളം ഇവിടെ കഥകളി കലാകാരൻ സ്റ്റാർട്ടിങ് മുതല് തന്റെ ജീവിതം അവസാനം വരെ പഠിച്ചുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുക. നമുക്കൊന്നും സങ്കല്പിക്കാൻ പറ്റാത്ത ഒരു വേഷ വൈചിത്രം ഈ കഥകളിക്ക് വന്നിട്ടുണ്ട്.
അപ്പൊ
ശരാശരി ഒരു കഥാപാത്രം നമ്മൾ ഒരുങ്ങി വരണമെങ്കിൽ 4 മണിക്കൂർ എങ്കിലും
സമയമെടുക്കും.
അപ്പൊ തീർച്ചയായിട്ടും ഈ ഇതൊരു ക്ഷേത്രകലയാണ്. നമ്മളിൽ ഒരു സംസ്കാരം വളർത്തിയെടുക്കുന്നതിനാണ് തീർച്ചയായിട്ടും ഈ പാരമ്പര്യ ആയിട്ടുള്ള കലകൾ അടുത്ത വരും തലമുറയെ. കഥകളി എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ എൻ്റെ ബ്ലഡാണ്, എൻ്റെ രക്തമാണ് കഥകളി എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞത്. എൻ്റെ മനസ്സും ശരീരവും കഥകളിക്ക് വേണ്ടിയിട്ട് അർപ്പിച്ചിരിക്കുന്നു ജീവിതം. അപ്പോൾ ഞാൻ എൻ്റെ ജീവിതം കഥകളിക്ക് കൊടുത്തു. അപ്പോൾ കഥകളി എൻ്റെ കൂടെ വന്നു. എൻ്റെ ജീവിതം ഞാൻ കഥകളിക്ക് വേണ്ടിയിട്ടു.
That was really cool.
Mm-hmm.
I love all the colors and the outfits.
Yeah, I actually forgot to tell you about the eye expression
thing.
Yeah,
that was very interesting.
Yeah, yeah, it's basically the expressions shown through the eyes is in fact the highlight. I mean, how many dance forms have you seen that have shown expressions through eyes? None.
None.
This is the only dance form that exists. That's why it takes years of practice, because you have to master the expressions shown through eyes. Like you, and the fun fact is you have to keep them wide open. Yeah. That's why they were like, in the beginning, they were like,
yeah,
practicing this.
That'd be so hard.
Because there is a significance to it. You know why? That's why if you notice, like the makeup and everything is kind of done so as to highlight the eyes.
Yeah, I noticed that.
Yeah. But yeah, that refreshed a lot of my childhood memories. Yeah.
Yeah.
That was cool.
But yeah, it's crazy. 12 years of study.
I knew it was a few years, but I didn't know it was 12 years.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's really crazy.
But it makes sense though, right? Like, because it's a very complicated dance form.
Mm-hmm.
It's not like someone can just like, hey, pick up some master class and just like learn it.
Yeah.
Because again, like, you have to master the eye movements. And one other thing that I forgot to mention was that it's actually a collaborative art form, as in it's not only the dancers performing, but it's also actually someone reciting the story. There is a narrator.
Uh-huh.
And then there is someone who is giving the vocals.
Uh-huh.
There is someone giving the music. So it's like a collaborative effort.
That makes sense.
Yeah. So everyone has to synchronize really well in order to pull this off perfectly.
And that's so hard.
That is so hard. Because if one person messes it up, then the whole form is gone.
Mm-hmm.
Then it becomes a big distraction.
I think we should learn a couple things with the eye expressions with our masks.
Well, that is
true. We should learn some eye expressions.
Yeah.
We have to smile with our eyes now.
Yeah, that is true. But not the fake smile though.
No.
Yeah, I've seen the fake smile.
Yeah.
If you guys don't know what we are talking about, just go on TikTok or on Google and just type in fake smile trend.
Yeah,
it's pretty funny. It's pretty funny. But yeah, I totally enjoy this video. It kind of, now I feel like you got a good introduction, and I feel like you should watch one app that will actually tell you how it's done.
Yeah.
Overall. So yeah, I'm pretty content with what we saw. And I hope you genuinely enjoyed the video.
Mm-hmm.
And got to learn something new.
Yes, I did.
Yeah. So many like cultural things that are still out there that, you know, not a lot of people know, that people need to know.
Yeah.
So I'm so glad that, you know, there are videos like this existing, because without videos like this, like, no one would ever know.
Yeah.
And it's so important to like pass it down to mm-hmm. other people, because everyone deserves to. And it's not just like, you know, traditions and culture that is like shown in Kerala, but also like different states and different countries. So if you guys have more such videos from different, that is unique, you know,
mm-hmm.
something unique to each and every state or maybe a country, do let us know, because we want to educate ourselves.
Yeah,
that's the whole point of, like, you know, creating this channel, so we educate ourselves and we get to learn more. So please do send in your suggestions, and I hope you guys enjoyed our reaction to this video, and not just reaction but also the discussion.
Yeah.
I think I got most of the things right before the video.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm kind of proud of myself. And I'm proud to be a Keralite. Yes. So I hope you guys enjoyed our video, and please follow us on social media platforms. And like I said, if you have such interesting videos for us to take a look at, please do let us know, because your suggestions are what keeps the channel going.
Mm-hmm.
So that was it for this video. We'll see you guys in the next video. Until then, time out. If you guys like this video, you guys know the drill. Like, share, comment, subscribe, and hit the bell icon notification button so you don't miss any other update. And if you guys have more such videos, please do send them our way. All of the details will be in the description box below.
And don't forget to check out our other videos and follow us on social media.